Hello and welcome to the 7 o'clock news from Bahrain International. I'm Sarah Bulfateh. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received at Sakhir Palace yesterday evening the Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas and his accompanying delegation. Present was His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa. A reception ceremony was held for the Palestinian president and the national anthems were played.
استاذن جلالتكم التفقد حرس شرف سيد
His Majesty the King and the Palestinian President then inspected the guards of honor.
Thank you.
His Majesty the King then greeted members of the Palestinian delegation, and the Palestinian President greeted senior Bahraini officials. His Majesty the King then held bilateral talks with the Palestinian President, during which they reviewed the strong brotherly relations between the two countries. They also discussed the latest developments of the Palestinian cause, as well as other regional and international issues. His Majesty the King and the Palestinian President then held a discussion session that was attended by the delegations of the two countries.
فخامة الرئيس محمود عباس رئيس دولة فلسطين الشقيقة سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة ملك البلاد المفدى حفظه الله ورعاه صاحب السمو الملكي رئيس الوزراء الموقر حفظكم الله ورعاكم أصحاب السمو أصحاب المعالي والسعادة السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته نرحب بكم في هذا اللقاء بمناسبة زيارة فخامة الرئيس الفلسطيني إلى مملكة البحرين وخير ما نبدأ به تلاوة عطرة من القرآن الكريم يتلوها على مسامعنا القارئ
Verses of the Holy Quran were recited.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ولقد سبقت كلمتنا لعبادنا المرسلين إنهم لهم المنصورون وإن جندنا لهم الغالبون فتول عنهم حتى حين وأبصرهم فسوف يبصرون أفبعذابنا يستعجلون فإذا نزل بساحتهم فساء صباح المنذرين وتول عنهم حتى حين وأبصر فسوف يبصرون سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين صدق الله العظيم
يتفضل سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة
His Majesty the King then delivered the following speech
بإلقاء كلمة بهذه المناسبة
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم فخامة الأخ الرئيس ضيوفنا وحضور الكرام يسعدنا كما هو الحال دوما أن نرحب بكم في ربوع بلدكم الشقيق الذي يكن لكم بقيادته وشعبه كل محبة وتقدير، والذي يقف مساندا في كل الأوقات والظروف لقضيته الأولى من أجل الوصول إلى حل عادل ودائم يحفظ للشعب الفلسطيني الأبي حقه الأصيل والمشروع في إقامة دولته المستقلة وعاصمتها القدس الشريف. وسيظل شعب البحرين مقدراً وممتناً للمواقف النبيلة والكريمة للشعب الفلسطيني على مر تاريخنا المشترك، والذي لم يتردد يوماً عن مد يد الخبرة والعلم والمعرفة ليساهم في إثراء مسيرة بناءنا الوطني التي لن تنسى أبداً عطاء وإسهام المخلصين من إخوتنا الأعزاء. أخي العزيز أبو مازن، يطيب لنا في هذا اللقاء المبارك أن نمنح فخامتكم وسام القلادة الخليفية للتعبير عن شكرنا وتقديرنا لجهودكم المشهودة في سبيل الدفاع عن قضايا أمتنا العربية ومساعيكم الجادة نحو تحقيق سلام عادل وشامل في المنطقة، وللتأكيد على دعم البحرين المستمر لحق الشعب الفلسطيني من العيش في سلام ورخاء تحت راية دولته المستقل، وبما يحفظ أمن واستقرار وطننا العربي الكبير، كما يشرفنا تكرمكم بمنحنا وسام القلادة الكبرى، وهي لفتة أخوية طيبة نشكركم عليها ونعتز بها أشد الاعتزاز. أخي الرئيس، إن العلاقة الأخوية الوثيقة التي تجمع شعبينا ستبقى عنواناً لشراكتنا المميزة ومسيرتنا الإنسانية الواحدة نحو نشر وتحقيق قيم ومبادئ السلام والتسامح والعدالة من أجل إرساء الخير والمحبة في العالم. ويسعدنا في ختام كلمتنا أن نكرر ترحيبنا بكم وبالأخوة الأفاضل أعضاء وفدكم الموقر على زيارتكم الكريمة لبلدكم البحرين، فأهلاً وسهلاً بكم بين أهلكم وعلى الرحب والسعة، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
His Majesty the King then granted the Palestinian President the Al-Khalifa Medal in appreciation for his role in supporting Bahraini-Palestinian cooperation and for defending the rights of Palestinians and enhancing their unity. For his part, the Palestinian President granted His Majesty the King Palestine's highest medal in appreciation for his role in strengthening Bahraini-Palestinian relations and for his efforts in supporting the Palestinian cause.
رئيس دولة فلسطين بإلقاء كلمة بمناسبة
The Palestinian President then delivered the following speech.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أخي صاحب الجلالة الملك، أخي رئيس الوزراء، أصحاب المعالي والسعادة، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أشكركم سيدي صاحب الجلالة من صميم قلبي على منح القلادة الخليفية السامية التي أعتبرها تكريماً أخوياً رفيعاً من جلالتكم ومملكة البحرين وشعبها الشقيق لفلسطين وشعبها. وبهذه المناسبة أعرب لجلالتكم عن جزيل الشكر والتقدير على ما تقدمونه من دعم لشعبنا الفلسطيني وحرصكم الدائم في جميع المناسبات على إظهار أهمية القضية الفلسطينية وضرورة إيجاد حل عادل لها، وكان آخرها كلمتكم السامعة في القمة العربية الأخيرة في الأردن الشقيق. وهنا نؤكد لجلالتكم وقوفنا الدائم إلى جانب مملكة البحرين وشعبها الشقيق، وعلى رفضنا المطلق لأي تدخلات خارجية في شؤونها، ونشيد بالجو الإيجابي السائد فيها. فالبحرين هي بلد التعايش والوئام، كانت ولا زالت وستبقى إن شاء الله إلى الأبد. أخي صاحب الجلالة، إننا نقدر عالياً رعايتكم لمؤتمر سفراء فلسطين الذي سينعقد غداً، وهي لفتة نبيلة نشكركم يا صاحب الجلالة عليها، وهي دليل أكيد على عمق العلاقات بين بلدينا وشعبينا الشقيقين. أخي صاحب الجلالة، يسعدني في هذه اللحظات التي ستبقى خالدة في ذاكرتنا، ويشرفني باسمي شخصياً وباسم شعبنا الفلسطيني الذي يكن لجلالتكم ولبلدكم وشعبكم الشقيق عظيم التقدير والمحبة، أن نقدم لكم القلادة الكبرى لدولة فلسطين، تقديراً لعطائكم ودفاعكم المخلص عن قضية أمتكم ومصالحها القومية العليا. سائلين الله أن يحفظكم وبلدكم وشعبكم، ويديم عليكم نعمة الصحة والسعادة والتوفيق في قيادة وطنكم نحو المزيد من الرخاء والتقدم والازدهار. عشتم يا صاحب الجلالة الأخ الحبيب، وعاشت مملكة البحرين وشعبها، وعاشت فلسطين والأخوة البحرينية الفلسطينية، وعاشت أمتنا العربية. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
His Majesty the King then held a dinner banquet in honor of the Palestinian President and his accompanying delegation.
Thank you.
His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa received today at Rafah Palace the Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas and his accompanying delegation. They stressed the importance of a unified Arab world regarding the Palestinian cause, especially under the recent international developments and the positive stances of major countries towards Arab issues, stressing the need to benefit from these advantages to achieve progress in Arab issues and the Palestinian cause and maintain security and stability of the region. His Royal Highness affirmed the importance of the Palestinian cause to all Muslims and stressed the need for a unified Arab action to achieve the aspiration of the Palestinians and all Arabs. He affirmed the kingdom's firm stances and full support to the cause and for its people to obtain their legitimate rights in accordance with the Arab Peace Initiative of 2002. His Royal Highness expressed appreciation to the Palestinian Committee and hailed their role in supporting the march of progress of the kingdom in various sectors. The Palestinian president invited His Royal Highness to visit Palestine and expressed thanks and appreciation to His Royal Highness's firm stances and continuous support to the Palestinian cause. He praised the wise vision of His Royal Highness towards issues facing the region. He also praised the stances of the Kingdom of Bahrain in various events and its efforts in defending the legitimate rights of the country. The Palestinian president affirmed the firm stances of Palestine towards Bahrain and wished the kingdom further progress and prosperity. He briefed His Royal Highness on the recent developments in Palestine and the efforts exerted by major countries to reach a solution that guarantees the freedom of the Palestinian people. The meeting also included topics related to regional and international affairs. Palestinian President then granted His Royal Highness with an honorary PhD from Al-Quds Open University in the presence of the Chairman of the Board of Trustees of the University Adnan Samara in appreciation to the stances of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, humanitarian and development initiatives, his continuous contributions to support Arab and Islamic issues and his unlimited support towards Palestine. His Royal Highness expressed thanks and appreciation to the Chairman of the Board of Trustees and the Academic Authority of the University University for being honored with the certificate and praised the scientific and the academic values of the university, as well as its wise vision and message to achieve progress and creativity in education. His Royal Highness affirmed the Kingdom's firm stances and support towards the Palestinian cause and stressed the need for unified and enhanced Arab action in international events to support the legitimate rights of the Palestinian people. The chairman of the Board of Trustees praised the leading role and efforts of His Royal Highness in enhancing Arab and joint action. He added that granting His Royal Highness a certificate is an honor for the university and praised the significant role of His Royal Highness on the Arab and international levels. The representative of His Majesty the King for Charity Works and Youth Affairs, Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports and President of Bahrain Olympic Committee, the BOC, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, received BOC's Secretary General Abdulrahman Sadiq Askar, who presented to His Highness Taekwondo national team player Fajr Al Bin Ali on the occasion of winning the gold medal in the International Taekwondo Federation Championship, which was held in Morocco. His Highness congratulated the player and the members of the Bahrain Defense Federation, as well as the members of the technical and administrative bodies of the team on the occasion of this achievement, in light of the support of the wise leadership. He affirmed support to youth and athletes to achieve advanced positions in such prominent championships in order to enhance Bahrain's position on the arena of sports. He noted the number of young talents in Bahrain who need support and care to enhance their abilities. The chairman of the Supreme Council for Islamic Affairs, Sheikh Abdullah bin Khalid Al Khalifa, chaired today the regular meeting where the council hailed the positive outcomes of the Arab summit that was held recently in Jordan, pointing out to the outcomes of the summit in supporting Arab issues and enhanced cooperation between brotherly countries. The council congratulated the Islamic nation on the occasion of Al Isra wal Mi'raj anniversary, which marks the night that Allah took the Prophet on a journey from Grand Mosque in Mecca to Al-Aqsa Mosque and then to heaven. The council also congratulated His Royal Highness Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa on being honored with Development Work Shield from the Arab League, highlighting the role and efforts of His Royal Highness in achieving sustainable development in various sectors. The council then strongly condemned the two terrorist bombings that targeted churches in Egypt. The council then concluded the meeting with reviewing letters and requests and taking the necessary decisions. under the patronage of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa and the Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas, and in the presence of Deputy Prime Minister Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak Al Khalifa, the Palestinian Ambassadors to Arab and Islamic Countries Conference was held today. The Palestinian President expressed thanks in his speech to His Majesty the King for supporting the Palestinian cause and for his attempts to find a just solution. He affirmed Palestine's support to Bahrain and its people. Abbas reviewed the efforts and endeavors that aim to raise an independent Palestinian state with the support of friendly countries. The Minister of Foreign Affairs, Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed bin Mohammed Al Khalifa, delivered a speech on this occasion in which he affirmed that Bahrain supports the efforts of the Palestinian President and the ambassadors of Palestine, which aim to enable the Palestinian people to overcome the great difficulties they face. The Foreign Minister noted the success of those efforts. Most recent is the historic resolution of 2334 adopted by the UN Security Council, demanding that Israel stops building settlements in the occupied Palestinian territories. He noted that the resolution is considered a Palestinian victory as it reflects an international consensus on the illegality of Israeli settlements and a rejection of the occupation, its practices and its consequences. Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed stressed that the Palestinian cause will continue to be a top priority in the Kingdom of Bahrain. He also noted Palestine's important position in the Kingdom's foreign policy, which supports all regional and international efforts aimed at finding a just and lasting solution to this issue based on the two-state solution in accordance with the resolutions of international legitimacy and the Arab Peace Initiative. He added that the two-state solution requires continued efforts and requires the international community to compel Israel to accept peace, respect international law and the relevant United Nations resolutions, and recognize the dangers of the continuation of settlements. The foreign minister expressed his hope for the establishment of an independent Palestinian state with East Jerusalem as its capital. He demanded Israel to support the two-state solution if it were to maintain security and stability for its people. Sheikh Khalid noted that this solution will create an environment of peace and coexistence in the region. For his part, the Palestinian Foreign Affairs Minister Riyad al-Maliki expressed thanks and appreciation to His Majesty the King and the government of Bahrain for hosting the Palestinian Ambassadors Conference for the second time, which reflects Bahrain's interest in the Palestinian cause and its support for its people. The Palestinian Ambassador to Bahrain, Taha Abdel Qader, commenced the conference with a speech in which he expressed thanks and appreciation to His Majesty the King for patronizing the event. He also expressed thanks and appreciation to Mahmoud Abbas for attending. Abdel Qader praised His Royal Highness Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, His Royal Highness Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Premier Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa for supporting the Palestinian cause, noting the efforts of the Foreign Affairs Minister to make the conference a success. Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak held the lunch banquet in honor of the Palestinian President and his accompanying delegation, as well as the Palestinian ambassadors to Arab and Islamic countries. The banquet was attended by Deputy Prime Minister Sheikh Khalid bin Abdullah Al Khalifa, the Speaker of the Shura Council Ali bin Saleh Al Saleh, and a number of ministers.
The Conference of the Ambassadors of the State of Palestine to Arab and Muslim Countries began today under the patronage of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa. The opening ceremony stressed support for the just Palestinian cause to reach a fair and durable solution to preserve the right of the Palestinian people to establish an independent state.
Important meeting to listen to President Mahmoud Abbas in a conference for the ambassadors of Palestine around the world to gather here in Bahrain, and for them and us to listen to the policy of Palestine and the struggle to gain their independence and their own country. And this was an opportunity to listen to a lot of important details.
This is the second time for receiving the Palestinian ambassador here for meeting. We highly appreciate that, and we are grateful for the support of His Majesty and the Kingdom of Bahrain.
The conference also consists of workshops that will go on until tomorrow evening and give the ambassadors a chance to gather and discuss the issues and challenges facing the state of Palestine, including terrorism.
We are always looking for the historical relations between Bahrain and Palestine, and that's why this conference is being held here in Manama, the capital of the Kingdom of Bahrain, to express our gratitude of historical relations, and at the same time to say that this is a lovely country and should always be safe from terrorism. And we should always keep the good relations with Bahrain, with Bahraini people. We always look for Bahrain as a brotherly country who is always supporting the state of Palestine. Inshallah, we hope that very soon we will declare the state of Palestine to be able to see, inshallah, a better future for the Palestinians.
I believe that the attendance on the part of the Bahraini government, as well as on the part of the ambassadors, was just quite phenomenal. And I'm under the impression this is reaffirmation that the Palestinian cause is and will remain to be the core of the problems in the area. And I was very impressed with the speech delivered by His Majesty and by President Abbas. He reaffirmed all the positions that are adopted. We are so pleased of the fact that the Arabs are speaking in one language and in one word, as opposed to the United States of America, to everybody. This is the position, and this is what would help us face the challenges that we are confronting.
The conference emphasizes the solid relations between the Kingdom of Bahrain and the State of Palestine, the latest Arab and Palestinian developments, as well as regional and international updates.
The opening ceremony of the Conference of the Ambassadors of Palestine in Arab and Islamic States was a success, and all participants are looking forward to the next 2 days of workshops. For Bahrain News, I'm Shoga Mohammed.
Speaker of the Representatives Council Ahmed Al-Mulla chaired today the weekly meeting where the council approved a draft law regarding military judiciary and a report regarding protection and support of national industries. The council approved a proposal regarding banning prawn fishing on the 9th of March of this year in order to maintain marine resources. The council also approved issuing a statement regarding condemning the terrorist bombings that happened recently in Egypt. The council then approved a proposal restricting the traveling to some countries that pose a threat to the security and stability of the Kingdom of Bahrain. The Minister of Education, Dr. Majid bin Ali Naimi, received at the National Charter Monument yesterday evening the Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas, who was accompanied with the Palestinian Foreign Minister, Dr. Riyad al-Maliki, the head of the Mission of Honor, the Minister of Information Affairs, Ali bin Mohammed al-Ramehi, and a number of senior officials and ambassadors. The Palestinian President expressed pride in visiting the landmark of the Charter, adding that it represents Bahrain's history and civilization. He praised the high level of education in Bahrain, as it was one of the pioneers in formal education. For his part, the Minister of Education welcomed the Palestinian President, highlighting the strong Bahraini-Palestinian relations. He added that the Ministry of Education, under the directives of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, places great importance on the National Charter Monument to implement the values of patriotism in the younger generations. The Palestinian President toured the place, which showcased different periods of Bahrain's history. He also signed in the senior guest book textbook, expressing admiration for Bahrain's historical and cultural march. Held under the patronage of the oil minister Sheikh Mohammed bin Khalifa Al Khalifa, supported by the National Oil and Gas Authority, the Middle East Heavy Oil Congress brings together NOCs, IOCs, technology and service providers to talk firsthand about existing and upcoming heavy oil projects. More in this report with Yasmin Ibrahim.
The Middle East Heavy Oil Congress offers 2 days of networking and knowledge exchange opportunities for heavy oil professionals from across the globe through a dedicated conference and an international exhibition showcasing latest technologies and offerings to heavy oil professionals.
The special topic is how do you apply new technologies and reduce costs of production, especially in an environment of low oil price. A lot of the technology is going to be discussed in this conference, and the experiences applied in countries like Oman and Kuwait and in Bahrain will also be discussed, along with the experience that we can see from places like Canada, which has vast resources of heavy oil.
The Congress aims to provide insight into the entire heavy oil value chain through project-focused case studies and panel discussions on the latest trends, challenges, and assessment of wide range of commercial opportunities delivered by both local and regional expert panelists and presenters.
The Middle East Heavy Oil Conference is important because there's a lot of heavy oil in this region. As we heard in some of the opening remarks, there might be upwards of 500 billion barrels of resource throughout the region, and some of it is here in Bahrain. So the challenge is, how do we produce it commercially? And the role that BAPCO plays in this conference is that we have the facilities, including the potential future facilities, that will allow us to convert this into the white oil products that the world needs. So with a big resource base and maybe a little bit of help from the oil price, we'll be able to produce that oil and generate revenue for the kingdom.
The main driving force was really that this is a heavy crude conference. Heavy crudes have high viscosities, and there our technology becomes very applicable. There are different aspects. First, it's the networking aspects. So we see a lot of our end users we see here. We come into discussions, and also we use it for the presentation. We have a presentation at the conference, and it's a great platform to be part of.
The Congress serves as a regional platform for heavy oil professionals to gather and help advance the heavy oil sector and to be a part of an ongoing transformation of the industry.
As the oil and gas industry continues to evolve, the second edition of the Middle East Heavy Oil Congress continues to contribute to the enhancement of the industry and global economies. Reporting for Bahrain International, I'm Yasmin Ibrahim.
The Minister of Housing, Engineer Bassem Bin Yaqub Al-Hamer, announced that the housing units distribution program will commence tomorrow. This comes as an implementation of the directives of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister Bin Salman Bin Hamad Al-Khalifa to establish 4,200 housing units for the citizens in different areas of the kingdom. Housing Minister stated that the program will start from the 12th of April until June 2017. He stated that the Housing Ministry is ready to receive citizens to finalize the distribution procedures, adding that the Ministry is keen on facilitating the procedures for citizens in order to complete the program as scheduled. On behalf of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Premier Prince Salman bin Hamad Al-Khalifa, the President of Bahrain Authority for Culture and Antiquities, the BACA, Sheikh Hamay bin Mohammed Al-Khalifa, inaugurated today at Bahrain National Theatre the Islamic Archaeology from a Global Perspective Conference. Prominent figures in the field of history and archaeology from around the world, as well as diplomats, media figures, academics and researchers attended the conference, which also celebrates the opening of Al-Khamis Mosque Visitor Center as a museum documenting the history of the most prominent Islamic archaeological site in the Arabian Gulf region. In her opening speech, Sheikh Hamay expressed thanks to His Royal Highness the Crown Prince for patronizing the event. She commended His Royal Highness's interest in the cultural and historical heritage that distinguishes the kingdom, adding that the conference will boost the programs of the Bahrain Culture and Antiquities Authority. BACA President said that it is time to look closely at the map of Islamic archaeology in the global context and to focus and care for Islamic archaeological sites in light of the exceptional challenges and external factors which limit the effectiveness of conservation efforts. She also expressed her desire for the establishment of an archaeology department at the University of Bahrain. Arab and Islamic Studies professors at the University of Exeter, Dr. Timothy Insull, delivered a speech in which he noted the importance of holding such a conference. He thanked His Royal Highness the Crown Prince for patronizing the event and commended the organization and wide participation.
People have lived on the islands of Bahrain for 6,000 years. There are traces of their rich and varied art and culture across the landscape or hidden in sands. It takes decades of archaeological work to unleash the stories of this unique heritage. Today's conference, Islamic Archaeology from a Global Perspective, was the fruit of major archaeological work undertaken by local and international teams. It celebrated the opening of the new Al-Khamis Mosque Visitor Center and Exhibition as the preeminent Islamic archaeological site museum in the Gulf region, drawing great international attention to Bahrain's strategic location and natural wealth.
We see a lot of experts here today in Manama, which express the importance of Bahrain and the archaeological locations in the area, especially with Bahrain Fort being one of the important sites.
Very, very important to have many international celebrity to come and lecture and participate.
Experts from the East and the West were there to witness the amazing discoveries and share the results of years of research in their own regions, reaffirming the global perspective.
We've drawn together specialists from around the world to come and speak about the archaeology of different regions of the Muslim world and beyond. So if people would like to come and visit, to come and see some of the papers, they're very welcome indeed.
It's an important element of heritage, and it's a souvenir of the past, and also to show us that there are many other things in Islamic civilization, which is obviously one of the world's great civilizations.
And hence the relationship between Bahrain and the rest of scholar world, because we are going to hear excellent scholars about the work that has been done here in Islamic archaeology, which is my specialty, is also the best.
Great experts and colleagues under one roof, studying for the first time, examining the Islamic archaeology and the Islamic art, historical art, from global perspectives.
Prehistoric Islamic sites, glorious mosques, temples and palaces were displayed in amazing lectures and documentaries, leaving everyone dazzled by Bahrain's wonders and rich history. Islamic archaeology attracts experts from all over the world here in Bahrain to listen to the untold stories of this great civilization. Reporting for Bahrain International, I'm Hiba Abdul Ghaffour.